In this video, we can solve a question from the Chinese Math Olympiad. Given the square root of x plus the square root of x plus 9 is an element of the natural numbers, find all integer solutions. This can be confusing at first glance, and unsure about how to approach it, since this is not an equation. Now let's see how to solve it. Because given the expression is a natural number, so that means the part under the square root must be a perfect square. So let's start by assigning a variable to this expression. So let the expression under the square root x plus the square root of x plus 9 equals n squared, a perfect square. So then let's introduce another variable. So let this part, the square root of x plus 9 equals another variable, t. Because this one is a square root, so here is a bigger than or equal to 0. So now we need to prove t is a positive integer. So let's see. So if t equals 0, so that means the inside part, x must be negative 9. So if you use negative 9, to replace x here and here, so then we have the square root of x plus square root of x plus 9, then just equals square root of negative 9, because this part is 0. But then square root of negative 9 is not a positive integer, so that means t cannot be 0. So that means t, this part, must be bigger than 0. So that means this part, the square root of x plus 9 equals 0, must be bigger than 0. Now let's square both sides. Then x plus 9 equals t squared. Because x is an integer, 9 is an integer, so that means t squared must be an integer. Because t squared is bigger than 0, so that means this one must be positive integer. So now let's solve for x. So then x equals t squared minus 9. So now let's label this result. Label this one as result 1. So now we're going to do the substitution. So from the first equation here, from this one, then from x plus square root of x plus 9 equals n squared, the first line of our solution. So then use t squared minus 9 to replace x. Then use a t to replace the square root. So then we have this equation. So that's t squared minus 9 plus t, this is a plus, equals n squared. Because you see, n squared, n t squared, and 9, they are all positive integers. So that means t must be an integer. Because t is bigger than 0, so that means t must be a positive integer. So now let's solve this equation. So now we have one equation with two variables. So now let's see how to solve it. So let's combine t squared with t. Then t squared plus t. Then we want to form a complete square. So now we need to add one more term. We need to plus 1 over 4. Then we need to minus 1 over 4. Then minus 9. Then equals n squared. So now let's combine these three terms together. So it's a perfect square. which is t plus 1/2 then squared. Combine these two together, which is 37 over 4, then equals n squared. So then t plus 1/2 then squared, move n squared to the left hand side, minus n squared, move this term to the other side, to the right hand side. Now let's factor the left hand side. So the first term minus the second term times the first term plus the second term equals 37 over 4. Both sides times 4. Then here 4 times t plus 1/2 minus n, then t plus 1/2 plus n equals 37. So now we want to get rid of the fraction here. So 4 equals 2 times 2. So we put a 2 combined with the first part. Then another 2 combined with the second part. Then equals 37. Now let's expand this part. Then just 2t plus 1 minus 2n. The second part, 2t plus 1 plus 2n equals 37. Because 37 is a prime number. It's a prime number. So then this is a prime number because t and n both are positive integers. So that means for this part, it's a positive integer. So that means this one positive integer, this one positive integer. So it means this one must be a positive integer. Because here's a minus, here's a plus. So that means that this term is less than the second term. So here is less than. Because 37 is a prime number, it has only two factors. One is 1, another one is self. So the two factors can only form one product, which is 1 times 39. So that means the smaller one equals 1, then the bigger one equals 37. Then we have the following equation. So then the first part, so that's 2t plus 1 minus 2n equals 1. Then the second part, 2t plus 1 plus 2n equals 37. Now let's solve these two equations. Let's label this one as equation 1, so this is equation 2. So now let's do equation 1 plus equation 2. Then that's 4t plus 2 equals 38. Then t equals 9. So then let's see what is the solution for x. Because from the result 1, you see, result 1, x equals t squared minus 9. So now let's plug in the result for x. So then x equals t squared minus 9. Then just 9 squared minus 9. Then just equals 72. 72 is a solution of this question. Thanks for watching.